Hello, this is Claude, and today I'm making a video about a microphone stand hack, about a very typical and a common microphone stand that is found on Amazon. It's a OnStage. This is the one right here, the base right here. This is the OnStage adjustable desk microphone stand. It's part number DS7200B, and this microphone stand is an adjustable stand. And also, there is a adjustable or a mini boom arm MSA9502 as well. So if a lot of people just like me like to have the microphone stand, the desk microphone stand there, but don't like to have I don't like to have these boom arm, the adjustable one, like the like a crane more or less, with all the springs and all. I like to have this thing there. But the thing is that this is adjustable for different lengths and heights and angles as well. So when you turn that, you can get the microphone stand going up and down and like this. All right. So I'm just gonna, make it. There you go, right there, fixed on this position. The thing that happens is that once you have that, if you let it go, it's just gonna fall, just gravity, right? So when I purchased the boom arm, I thought that the bottom was going to be sturdy enough for that, and it's not. So I'm just going to introduce a little hack, something that we can do to make it stay the way it's supposed to be. So if you look at this, the diameter of the I'm going to put it on the side here. The diameter of the arm is exactly 7/8 of an inch. Okay, so that's what it is for the dimension diameter, 7/8 of an inch. So the best way to do is to add some weight to the base. All right, and I'm going to do it right now. Add weight to this base right here. So 7/8 of an inch. And what I do is I get the cap barbell, 5 pounds. All right, standard free weight barbell plate. And the diameter of the opening here, they're all supposed to be standard at 1 inch. And I've got that 1 inch and maybe a little more. Okay, so this is going to go straight into that 7/8 diameter shaft of the boom there. So what I'm going to do is, first of all, I'm going to protect the base. All right, don't want to have it scratch. I'm going to take little feet that I have, silicone feet. I'm going to put 4 of them and be able to protect the base. 2, 3, and put the last one here, 4. Make sure we're not going to scratch that with the barbell. So this is installed. After that, we're going to just remove the base. There we go. One is already out. Okay. I'm going to remove the base. There you go. Two of them fell, so I'll put it back up just at the end. Unscrew that baby right there. Remove the base. Put the barbell face up. You have two faces there. You got one that's not as good, one that looks better. Put the one that looks better on top. Let's put this base back in. Right. This is not the best angle, but I got it right there. Rescrew that in. And it's fixed right here. Okay, let's hold this baby there. Put the little feet back on because, like, the thing is very slippery on top. Put the little feet and just drop this right here. And you have now, doesn't look bad at all. It's exactly the same diameter for the 5 pound, is 6 inches and, if I recall, 6 1/4. 6 1/4. I've got my little Milwaukee, very handy measuring tape. So yeah, 6 1/4. So by having this now, you can have your thing there, and you don't need to, clamp, your the base to the desk using that. So it is now totally freestanding. So a 5 pound. Like I said, I'm gonna put all the links below in the description. Hopefully, I'm gonna be helping someone with the same situation. So hey, if you appreciate this, like the video, makes a difference, and consider subscribing to my channel. All right, thank you for watching, and see you at the next video. Bye bye.